Student, I believe you are having a great time. Today we shall be looking at communication, the second part. Lesson objectives. By the end of the lesson, students should be able to explain types of communication, identify communication networks in Nigeria. Types of communication. Remember last week we talked about communication as a means of sending and receiving information. And we looked at various importance of communication as well as traditional medium of communication, where we talked about talking drum, town choirs, metal gong, palm fronds, smoke signal, gun blasts, and others. But today we want to look at the types of communication that we have. So the first one on the list is called written communication. This is a written form of written form. Of communication where messages are sent and received in written form. So written communication provides permanent record for information. For example, letter, fax, email. Some people, they still have letters sent to them many years ago. So that is what we call written communication. Advantages of written communication. Number one, it provides permanent records. Written communication can be there. Your letter can be stored for a long period of time. Document in written form can be stored for a long period of time. Remember, histories of men that have been read today were written many years ago. But today we can still access them because they are in written form. Two, it removes necessity of personal contact. Since you can send messages in written form from one place to another, you do not need to be present. You do not need personal contact with the person, either the sender or the receiver. Three, the receiver can read the message as often as he wants. The receiver can go over the message, the written communication, over and over again. So it is more reliable than oral communication. Oral communication can be forgotten, but written communication is more reliable. Most of the time, it serves as evidence. Number five, it can be used in court of law. Yes, written communication can be used in the court of law as evidence. So now we have disadvantages of written communication. It takes more time to prepare. It involves thinking, putting words together, writing them. So those processes take time. Number two, it can be expensive to produce written message. Remember, to produce a book is not easy. You have to go through a lot of processes before you type it, before you collate it, before you put it in pages, before you send it to printing. And at the end of the day, the price of selling that book will be high. So it can be expensive to produce written message. Three, it creates maintenance problem in terms of space as bulky files and piles of paper are used. Yes, if you get to some library, you see bulky, unused written communication, that is books piled up there. So it takes a lot of space, it takes a lot of maintenance when it comes to written communication. Two, oral communication. This is mouth-to-mouth discussion or face-to-face means of communicating. It can even be over electronic media, such as you can call on phone, that is telephone. You can do chatting, video calls is also means of what? Communication. Advantage of oral communication, it is very fast. Yes, it is very fast. Within seconds, you are connected to the person you want to communicate with. Two, it provides immediate feedback. Since it's face-to-face discussion, you get your feedback, your reaction, the reaction of the person you are communicating with immediately. It is easier to maintain. You don't need to keep them, to pile them up in a place. You can maintain them. It costs little money. Disadvantages of oral communication. It consumes precious time. Yes. Some people can keep talking and talking and talking and talking and talking for hours. It lacks aid to human memory. It means it can be easily forgotten. Remember sometimes when you are taught in the class and you go for a break, by the time you return, you forgot what you were taught. That is one of the disadvantages of oral communication. But that which you write in your notes, you can go over them and read them one over and over again. It can be distorted or misunderstood because of our level of knowledge. Our level of knowledge or our level of understanding differs. So, oral communication can be distorted, can be misunderstood. Number three, non-verbal communication. This is the use of symbol, facial expression, pictures, gesticulation, e.g. traffic signs. Sometimes when you are angry, you may not need to talk. Merely looking at your face, the person you are angry with will know, this guy is angry. And when you are laughing, when you are happy, you don't need to shout it, I am happy. You only need to express it with either laughter. About doing that, people know, this one is happy. That is what we call non-verbal communication. Advantages of non-verbal communication: it saves time. Yes, it saves time. Just in a while, you have expressed your feelings, and that's all. Two, it solves the problem of linguistic. You don't have to be thinking about, what will I say? So I won't make a mistake. So I won't commit blunder, and so on and so forth. Three, it makes verbal communication more effective by supporting visual stimuli. Now, when you are communicating and you are gesticulating and you are reacting, you see that what you are doing will support your verbal communication. It makes it more effective. If you look at the actors and actors, yes, by the time they are acting, they are gesticulating, they are expressing their feelings. As they are talking, they are expressing their feelings. So it gives us more understanding of what they are trying to pass across. Disadvantages of non-verbal communication: only simple and limited messages can be sent. Yes, only simple is limited in scope. It can go beyond some area. It is limited in scope. This form of communication can be easily understood. So many people may not understand it. It is expensive when photographic films are used. Yes, photography costs a lot. So when photographic films are used, it is costly. Number four, we have visual communication. This is a form of communication which involves the use of the sense of sight or eyes only in disseminating information. When you're watching your TV, you're focused on it. You make use of your what? Sense of seeing, that is sense of sight, your eyes. Film show, you make use of what? Sense of seeing. You don't communicate, you only see. People you are watching are passing certain information across to you. Advantages of visual communication: it can reach many people at a fixed date and time. The information can be stored, yes. It can store piles of movies in a place over many years. It doesn't waste time, you watch it and that's all. It can also be useful to the deaf but literate people. Yes, you can also use it to teach the deaf that are also literate. Disadvantages of visual communication: it may be expensive to operate, e.g. television. The cost of buying TV now is very high. So for that to happen, the visual communication can be very expensive. It can only reach the wealthy and literate people of the society. Even in this era, we are, some still do not have television. Some cannot afford going to cinemas to watch film show. So definitely it is limited in scope because it can only reach few set of people. Number three, questions cannot be asked on matter being discussed on the television. You can't ask questions when you're watching film. You can say, why did you do this? Why did you do that? So, it's still talking about the limitation in its scope. So, those are the types of communication that we have. Now, let's go to communication network in Nigeria. Though these are discussed in detail next class, so let's quickly go over them. We have the telecommunication. The telecommunication has to do with sending signals, images, messages over a long distance by telephone and satellite. So you have the postal service and the sending and receiving of verbal messages across the world. We have the television, which we just discussed. We have the radio, we have the newspaper, we have the internet, we have the satellite, we have the courier service. We shall discuss all this in detail next class. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day. We shall meet again next week.